Tonight, history will be made. One championship's inaugural Atomweight Kickboxing World Championship is on the line. Yodcherry Sityodtong stakes her claim as one of the best Muay Thai athletes of her generation. Her opponent, Kai Ting Killer B Chuang, is a three-time WAKO kickboxing champion, and her sting comes by way of her fearsome striking. The winner becomes the first ONE Super Series women's title holder. ONE Championship's Battle for the Heavens, live from Guangzhou, China, starts now.
Welcome to the most exciting global martial arts event. It is ONE Championship.
Shock the world with an upset victory. It's a first round finish for the champion. We have a new ONE Championship title holder. What a shocker. Quite possibly the biggest upset we may ever had in ONE Championship.
You're watching the best of ONE Championship. In the main event, multiple-time Muay Thai world champion Yodcherry Sityodtong took on three-time WAKO champion Kai Ting Chuang in the first-ever ONE Kickboxing Atomweight World Championship. The two martial artists put on a spectacular striking display that got the crowd on their feet. Let's join this championship match in round three.
Third round, here we go.
Round three.
Go!
Let's see if Yodcherry can get those right roundhouses off. And a boxing flurry on the inside. Kai Ting Chuang backs her up. Yodcherry throws it into the ribs. What a flurry on the inside there from Kai Ting Chuang.
Man, that was like a five-punch combination. A left kick and then another three punches. Kai Ting Chuang is putting it on Yodcherry at least in the 30 seconds of this third round.
Overhand right to a straight left there from Kai Ting Chuang.
Good job. Yodcherry uses that push kick to keep the distance away. I'd like to see her use more of that, especially, there she is, especially as Kai Ting Chuang starts to rush in.
Kai Ting Chuang catches the roundhouse kick on the forearms, trying to force Yodcherry back. Yodcherry's got that right hand cocked and ready. She fires the right roundhouse kick. Ting Chuang finds a cut off the ring, goes for the inside thigh. Gets on the inside now, they tie up. Knee guard put on by Yodcherry, and referee Onari breaks them.
The kick is landing from Yodcherry, and also those knees inside the clinch. And in typical Muay Thai, those attacks score higher. Oh, not so much here.
Front kick to the face and a roundhouse kick to the body from Yodcherry. Beautiful work there from the Thai, and she knew she did well. Smiles towards her corner. Three sets again here. Front kick from Kai Ting Chuang. Gotta fire some more of those hands. Get the combinations working. Back up Yodcherry. Now she does that. Pumps in the jab. Knee guard from Yodcherry. Left kick from Kai Ting Chuang. What tenacity, what ferocity, and the Chinese fans that have packed out the Tianhe Gymnasium in Guangzhou, enjoying every moment of it. Chuang kicks off both legs there from Kai Ting Chuang. Comes in jabbing, resets again, gets out of the way of the right roundhouse kick. Resets her position, goes the body. Yodcherry locks her down. Both ladies throw the knees. Half a minute remaining in the third round.
Go!
The crowd roars as she does. Throws a knee to the bread basket.
Ready, go!
Back and forth round this one. Both athletes have had their chances. Had their good spells. Knee guard again from Yodcherry Sityodtong.
Go!
Just loses her footing. No knockdown, of course.
But that was a nice sweep, though. Yodcherry, she caught the push kick, pivoted off to the side, and that's what caused Kai Ting Chuang to end up on her butt. But a nice, look at this, that was that combination. That was a boom, 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 over and over, pushing forward. Nice little push kick there from Yodcherry.
We move ahead to the final round.
Final round!
Kai Ting Chuang is so intense. Yodcherry needs something dramatic in this fifth and final round if she wants to leave Guangzhou with the belt.
This crowd in Guangzhou on the edge of their seats for this one. 3 minutes remaining of what has been a fantastic round. Yodcherry fires back. There's the right roundhouse kick from Yodcherry. And now you can feel the aggressive meter has really risen. The
Now, Yodcherry is not backing up. She's standing her ground and exchanging. She's not letting Kai Ting Chuang push her back.
Yodcherry got that right roundhouse kick set to launch. There she goes, and she goes to the waist.
See how she's dropping that hand to parry? Right is there, right there.
Yodcherry Sityodtong, no knockdown there, of course. That's a beautiful takedown, a beautiful turnaround. Global reset.
I think Reece McLaren liked that one.
Front kick there, high check from Kai Ting Chuang. Yodcherry has certainly upped her aggression in this final round. You see, Kai Ting Chuang has practiced in training, catching the roundhouse kicks off the right leg and countering them with the right hand.
Right now would be perfect for Yodcherry to go up top. Kai Ting Chuang is reaching for that low kick, fake the low kick, question mark, boom, head kick.
You called it, Mitch, question mark kick, Brazilian kick, whatever you want to call it, it would work right now for Yodcherry Sityodtong. Both ladies trained the knees, and referee Onari breaks them. We've only got 1:10 remaining for the world title. Who's going to become the Atomweight champion? Dancing is Kai Ting Chuang. There's the roundhouse kick from Yodcherry. Doubles up in the captain counter from the Chinese athlete. Back through against the ropes. Under a minute to go now. Who is going to put the foot down? Who's going to press the turbo? And Kai Ting Chuang dancing again. Trying to confound Yodcherry Sityodtong. There's the roundhouse kick. It stops Kai Ting in her tracks. Catching counter again from Kai Ting Chuang. 20 seconds now, Dragon.
Yodcherry needs to fake that roundhouse kick and throw a punch. Kai Ting Chuang is consistently dropping that lead hand. It's there. The question mark, the head kick is there.
We're going to go down to the judges unless this one big silver left the right hand from Kai Ting Chuang. Yodcherry tries for a knee, puts on the knee guard. And it's going down to the judges. Whether you're watching it on 138 Classic or live on the One Super App, how do you score it?
Wow, the young lady is put on a show in Guangzhou. Look at this back and forth action, the combinations. Look at that, beautiful, caught the low kick, spun it to the side, came straight through with the right hand. Inside the clinch, this is that headlock takedown. Oh, puts Kai Ting Chuang on her back again. What a match.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the One Super Series Kickboxing Atomweight World Champion from the
and then raised and rescued by her grandparents, is now standing on top of the world.
That is something special. That is
return, Chinese star Fu Chong Sin takes on Rustem Yensabayev from Kazakhstan. You're watching the Best of One Championship. Welcome back to the Best of One Championship. China's Fu Chong Sin was out to impress the home crowd when he faced Kazakhstan's Rustem Yensabayev, and the Chinese martial artist did not disappoint.
Corner. Fu Chong Sin of China.
Judge.
Rustem Yensabayev of
Judge.
Kazakhstan.
Ready? Ready? Go!
It is all part of one championship battle for the heavens.
Fight.
From Guangzhou, China. High kick from Yensabayev. Spinning hook kick from the Taekwondoan in Fu Chong Sin. Nice cutting side kick there from Fu. Said he'd like to wind up some of the Taekwondo technique. We are seeing the kicks come into play early for Fu Chong Sin. Inside leg, nice and high on the thigh from Yensabayev, then goes upstairs. Whipping high left roundhouse kick, going for the headache maker, Fu Chong Sin.
Definitely an exchange of the kicks right now. That's all these guys want to throw. Yensabayev's got a little bit of a reach. I'd like to see him throw out that jab, set this up.
Catch and counter from Yensabayev. Got munching knee on the way up from the Kazakh, and they break. Both men more kick than a chorus line in the opening minute. Jab from Fu Chong Sin. Cagey, unorthodox footwork, the high left roundhouse kick. They call it Dolyo Chagi in Taekwondo. And he cut off the movement here, the Kazakh Yensabayev. Controlling center ring, there's a nice popping jab from him at full extension. Body shot off the backhand from Fu Chong Sin.
Yensabayev has been training in Shenzhen, China. So he says he's been working a lot on his striking out there.
And you see some of that more cagey stance work from Fu Chong Sin. Now both men center of the ring, inside leg kicks from Yensabayev. Perhaps a counter right hand could be the making. There it is from Fu Chong Sin.
Got a sneaky left jab from Yensabayev. He's really cutting through the guard nicely, and he's setting up that leg kick.
Fu Chong Sin threads the jab. There's a high kick again. That Dolyo Chagi goes to the body. Yensabayev tried to pull the head down. There's a nailing right hand. Good jab from Fu Chong Sin. Oh, little fake upstairs, driving takedown from Fu Chong Sin. Now we see the wrestling come into play.
It was the double leg we were talking about, Michael. Fu Chong Shin's got a nice double leg, but look at Yensabayev now trying to lace in that guillotine.
Yensabayev staying calm, gives up on the guillotine attempt. We've seen the Taekwondo, we've seen the boxing, we've seen the wrestling. A full martial arts display so far from Fu Chong Sin of China. Wrist control breaks up, back to center ring. 1 minute 55 remaining, first round. There's the jab of Fu Chong Sin and the high left roundhouse kick. There's a cut under the eye of Fu Chong Sin. Here comes Yensabayev, a high knee. Backs him up with a right hand. Yensabayev wants to go toe to toe. Takes him down again, goes to side control.
As you can see, Fu Chong Sin has a clear grappling advantage and does not want any more of the striking of Yensabayev. Yensabayev able to get him on top and lets it right hook go.
Side control here. Fu Chong Sin, what a first round! What a back and forth! The elbows raining down! This car going crazy! Fu Chong Sin, house on fire!
And Yensabayev's head
could be over! Could be over!
by him, but an impressive debut from Fu Chang Shin. Check this out. Look at that knee to the body. Turns him over and then just starts letting it go. Yuji Shimada's very close. Checking on Yen Zabayev, see if he's got anything coming back. But the Kazakh had no answer for the ground and pound.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 32 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Fu Ta-Chi!
Could be a contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night. It was powerful, it was damaging, it was Fu Ta-Chi! Remember the name, because I think you're gonna hear a lot more from Fu Ta-Chi. Complete performance, boxing, wrestling, taekwondo, the three martial arts this man is proficient in, and we saw them all.
The flyweight contest between Reece McLaren and Tatsumitsu Wada provided the best grappling of the night. The Australian grappler tried his hardest to secure the rear naked choke and later an armbar, but Wada remained calm and displayed tremendous defense. Similarly, when the Japanese warrior dragged McLaren to the ground, the Australian maintained his cool and even threw elbows and strikes from the bottom. It was a close battle, but McLaren left Guangzhou with the split decision victory. Chow Chi Kong thrilled the home crowd with this submission victory against compatriot Ma Shi Dong.
Ma Shi Dong to pick him up.
Still stuck in the guillotine here. Is it trouble for Ma Shi Dong? It's goodnight, Irene! Ma Shi Dong goes 9-9 in Guangzhou!
Shuya Kamikubo made a successful one debut in Guangzhou with this TKO of Indonesia's Sunoda.
Kamikubo trying to crack through the forearms. Olivia Koss says no more. What a performance from Shuya Kamikubo.
When we return, Andre Mounier and Ibrahim Elbouni put on a kickboxing show to remember in Guangzhou. You're watching the Best of One Championship. Welcome back to the Best of One Championship. Ibrahim Elbouni made a resounding statement in his ONE Super Series premiere when he took on Andre Mounier from Australia. Both men are known for knocking out their opponents, and as expected, one of them hit the canvas courtesy of some heavy strikes.
This match is 3 rounds of 3 minutes in a Super Series kickboxing catchweight contest! Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is an A1WCC kickboxing world champion, standing at 196 centimeters tall, holding a striking record of 36 wins and 6 losses. Training out of Jim Harlem, representing Morocco. Please welcome Ibrahim, Mr. Cool Elbouni. And now, introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He is a 4-time kickboxing world champion, standing at 191 centimeters tall, holding a striking record of 42 wins and 7 losses. Training out of Team Ultimate Gym Australia and representing Australia! Put your hands together for Andre the Giant Mounier!
Mounier, a wicked right hand and a fantastic body shot.
Go!
Look out for the left hook and the knees on Elbouni. Andre the Giant, big overhand right early on from the man from Melbourne. Long reaching jab, Elbouni's got the reach over the Giant here. Andre's been dropping sparring partners weighing up to 150 kilos. In training over the last 6 weeks, been dropping most of them with shots to the liver. Front kick there from the Giant, and a whipping high kick.
Go!
Jab from Elbouni. Andre pushes him back.
There's been a lot of trash talk between these two all week, Michael.
Here come the big swinging hands of Andre Munoz. Albuni ties him up, and referee Onari breaks them.
Go!
They got into it a little at the weigh-in earlier this week. Just the stare downs between the two. You could feel the intensity.
Stop!
There was a sporting hug after it. But you know these two men would love to get a knockout here. And you can feel the intensity inside this arena here, Mitch.
Everybody's waiting for that one big shot that could end the night for either one of these guys.
Andre got to be careful not to dip the head down. Wild hooking punches there from Albuni. Andre backs him up with the right hand.
Ooh, he caught him on the side of the
catch a knee coming in there? He might have caught a knee coming in. Referee puts a count on the giant. Well, he rushed in on Albuni.
Six. Seven,
I think got eight, tagged right behind the back of the ear.
Okay, to go on here, wipes off the gloves. Munier, the eyes aren't quite there. Albuni looks to capitalize. Andre in a bad spot here. Big right hand from Albuni, sets him down. And that's a knockout for Andre Albuni in the very first round. Well, he stunned Munier in the first knockdown. Munier rushed in on him. Ibrahim caught him in something. That was the beginning of the end. Munier couldn't recover. Great sportsmanship showing there, though. Tremendous heart and martial arts spirit between these two big fellas.
Man, the irresistible force met the immovable object. Munier was rushing in, throwing shots, but a beautiful sidestep by Albuni to tag him. That was the second knockdown, but I want to see that first knockdown again.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 31 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Ibrahim Albuni!
You can see the timing, you can see the precision of the man they call Mr. Cool. Great performance from Andre the Giant Munier. And tonight belongs to Ibrahim Albuni of Morocco and the Netherlands. Precision in the execution from Mr. Cool. A winner's medal goes back to Amsterdam. Around the neck of this tower of power.
Simpatch Vertex faced Lithuania's Davidas Danila in a Muay Thai bantamweight clash that went the distance. Both martial artists tested each other with their best strikes. A monstrous left hand followed by a left elbow sent Danila crashing to the canvas in the first round. In the second round, Simpatch battered his rival with lightning-fast jabs and whipping kicks. In the final round, the Thai warrior showcased his savvy clinch work with elbows and kicks from the inside. Although Danila connected with solid punches, it was a little too late to sway the judges. Simpatch earned the unanimous decision victory. Peng Shui Wen may be known for his wrestling prowess, but in Guangzhou, he used his dangerous knockout power to defeat seasoned boxer Eddie Kalai.
Big right hand down the chute. Down goes Eddie Kalai. Here's the ground and pound, and there's the finish. That's one win on the board for Team China.
Two-time Muay Thai world champion Estela Nunes clashed with six-time Philippine Wushu champion Gina Inyong. They both showcased their world-class striking skills throughout the three-round contest. In the end, Nunes used her high-octane style to secure a unanimous decision victory. Robin Catalan submitted Indonesian star Adrian Mateus with this stunning heel hook.
Oh, Catalan's going after a leg again. Looks like he's possibly got a heel hook.
Yep. And he has indeed.
You've been watching the Best of One Championship.